Hello and welcome to NDTV. I'm Rohit Khilnani. Joining me is a very talented team of actors. Guys, firstly, welcome to NDTV. Thank you for giving me time.
Thank you.
Abhishek, you did a nice introduction just before we were rolling. You want to give it a shot again, some of it?
Take two.
Then what we'll do is...
I want to say, hey, to my player.
That's only my Instagram hash.
Then let's see if I can ask you anything different after that.
You heard it, so let's just see.
Okay.
Yeah.
Guys, are you all aware of the buzz about Anurag directing a love story?
There's a buzz?
I'm very happy to hear that.
You were anxious in the middle of the night that there is no buzz, but let me tell you, there is a lot of buzz.
Yeah?
So, yeah.
There is, thank you.
You know what happens, Rohit, is I think, we get so busy doing...
Right.
You know, the maximum hustle and bustle for a film unit happens, like... Right. The month of release.
Hmm.
You actually work harder in promotions than you actually do on a film set. Because on a film set, you at least get that 15, 20, half an hour, downtime in between shots and all that. This is relentless. So you kind of just lose touch with what's going on. And so I like talking to you because then you kind of bring us down to earth. Either we think that, film is fantastic and then it opens at like 2 lakhs. And true story. Or, we don't really know. So,
right.
And also, for the three of us, we've lived this film for the last 6 to 8 months.
Right.
It's been part of our everyday and currently day and night. That's all we're doing. So you kind of lost objectivity about it.
Right.
So
no,
please tell us. Yeah.
No,
say
there
nice
is.
Things.
No. I'm saying real things and there's enough buzz about it. Before coming, I read up some other interviews that you all have done and Anurag and you guys. So there was obviously the most excitement on the chatter on social media was Anurag directing a love story. So have you all heard of all that chatter on social media?
Yeah, we've been answering those questions since since the time we started promoting the film, and we like this curiosity and question mark.
But was there a reaction first when you were told that?
No, actually, it was not. I didn't think that deep into it. There were other concerns before that. There were first of all, when I heard the script from Kanika, I heard it from Kanika first, and they were like, you need to answer right away, now, and tell us if you want to do it. And I was like, okay, but what's the urgency? Suddenly, like, the world is going to fall apart, what is going to happen? So I heard the script, and then I understood after hearing the script, why do they want me as Rumi? But then there's certain things that Rumi does in the film, which
why they want you as Rumi?
Yeah, because Anurag Kashyap firmly believes that this is 100%, I'm 100% Rumi.
Okay.
Tell the truth.
90%.
He knew that I'm going to cast Vicky and Abhishek. I'm going to have to work really hard on both of them. I need somebody that isse acting mat karwao. Just be.
That's yourself.
Yeah. There were things in the film that she did or she believes in that I don't. She's very convincingly confused, Rumi, and I'm not. So I was like, certain things that I said, okay, I'm not sure if this I'm okay with, or if as an audience I'll connect with my protagonist, like if she does this and all. So then she was like, this is the challenge for you. Otherwise, it's not a challenge. So that really convinced me, and that made me feel that if you have someone like Anurag Kashyap and Anand, it's worth taking that leap of faith. And that's why I did it.
Hi guys.
Hi.
This is common. This is their regular. They just go on a different trip.
Right. Abhishek, I read that you also heard this story from Kanika, and why did you think that this is a great one to do after a gap?
For two reasons. Firstly, I think what Kanika was trying to say in her material was, I thought, very novel for me to read, and I just liked the message she was trying to put across, very subtly, but I liked that, and it had to deal with, I think, a theme that today's generation will really kind of connect with, which is, for me, it was my personal interpretation, which is, which became kind of like the tag of the film, that what the heart desires, and it's as simple as that. There's no explanation, there's no reasoning. And there should definitely be no judgment.
Right.
I liked the idea that, take for example Rumi's character. She is what she is, she believes in what she believes, and she loves what she loves, and that's it. And there's no reason for it, and she doesn't ask for anybody's endorsement of it.
Right.
And nor does she want anybody else's endorsement. It's that way it's a very personal thing for her. And same with Vicky's character and mine. And I like that. I thought it was a new way to approach a love story.
Right.
You know, usually a love story has a lot to do with social norms, what's acceptable, what's not.
Yeah, yeah.
None of that was a criteria in this film. So that was new for me. I like that. And secondly, you already have this kind of material and Anurag coming in and putting his spin on it.
Correct.
I thought that
was
would be
that an element of surprise that Anurag will be directing?
Surprise, as in, yeah, it was a wonderful surprise. And, you know, I've always said the minute they told me Anurag is directing it, it was like, I mean, almost instantly it was a yes, you have to be a part of this. Because you knew if you're going to arm Anurag with this kind of material, he's just going to do something so unique and so cool that you have to be a part of it.
Right, right. Vicky, are you enjoying the stardom? I read an interview where you're saying when people say that I'm still getting used to this. Are you enjoying all the attention, all the love?
Yeah, I think I am in the state of transit
right
now because it's still not sinking in, which I think is a good phase to be in.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, but it feels good. It's a very gratifying experience. And it really does feel good.
And it is all real. Let me tell you, when we tell people that we are going to interview Vicky Kaushal, girls are like, can we come along and can we take a picture? So there's a lot of that coming your way now.
Have you got them along?
Yeah, three of them are here. We'll take pictures after the interview.
I see only men.
Okay. Guys, you know, in today's day and age, when people fall in love and meet at a click of a button, is it tough to please this kind of an audience with a love story like this? And there are many other love stories in the making. There's Leila Majnu, there's this one. This is an all new audience that has a different perspective. Is it tough to convince? Yeah, please.
Please.
I think that is a criteria that all three of us were very conscious of. And I think one of the reasons why I think everybody was excited about this is that this generation is going to get this love story. I really do believe without, you know, they say choti muh badi baat, but I really believe this is going to define for this generation what a love story is. And that's driven entirely through Taapsee's character.
Right.
You know, and I really believe in today's generation, which is at a push of a button, this is a film they're going to understand because it's their perspective.
Right.
It's their story. It's how they think.
Right.
You know, I'm not averse to, you know, everybody loves a classic love story and everybody wants to be a part of it. Everybody wants to see it. We still believe in dreams and fairy tales and that's great. And we should continue to sell that utopia.
Right.
This is real. This is how it actually is. This is what they think and they're completely going to get this. So I really hope and pray that the younger generation really just carries this film because it's their love story.
Right. You guys, yes, you guys on the same page with that, at least that, you know, there is space for good love stories, there's place for good...
I think the definition, or so to say, at least the perception of love and how to go about it changes after every few years.
Right.
With a lot of other things around
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So I think that is why this is today's day and age, the millennials love story, which, you know, everyone is going to connect to. They'll feel, okay, these things that they do or the characters they're all going to relate to and say, okay, this has a part of me. Oh, this I've gone through. That is 100% going to happen
right.
Because, you know, with the choices we have, with the accessibility today, I think this is how love really happens now.
Right. Is it tough to please these millennials because they are so distracted with mobile phones and all kinds of social media? Is it tough? Do you think it's going to be tough?
They
to
are very
them?
Demanding audience.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Why do you say that? Why do you?
Because that's just I think time has evolved like that. You know, our attention span has gone down. I mean, you see it all around, not just in films. I mean, I remember in the 80s, I mean, a 3.5-hour film or a 3-hour film was the norm. Today, anything above 2.5 hours, and they're like, wait a second. So that duration. You see our cricket, I mean, from test cricket now we're to T20, and I believe there's a 10-over format that's being proposed.
Right.
So everything is becoming shorter, everything is becoming rapid, it's instant gratification.
Right.
I don't think this generation thinks 10 years down the line.
Right.
It's what are we going to do today? I mean, tomorrow also is like, that. We'll see tomorrow.
Right. I've seen a lot of credit for you to do Mulk. Tell us, this comes just after that, right? So tell us, how's this phase been, where a lot of compliments, a lot of praise?
One side I keep hearing, of course, that you know, it's too soon. Everything is back to back. But thankfully, nobody's like getting bored of it. Thankfully,
of
because it's just so different from the other.
Yeah.
So that really feels nice that they're accepting me in different looks or genres and kind of films, and this in all possible ways will be the finale for me for this year because it is something. I've never done love story before this in my South or Hindi career. Like,
really?
A intense, dramatic love story. Mm. I haven't done that before. Okay. So, and I've always aspired to get one. Mm. So, this I think has totally. It's justice for all those 8 years I've been yearning to do one love story, and it's
this
finally
is it.
this is it. So it is a perfect end of the year for me, right, for my releases this year, which I'm really looking forward to. That's why I think this is the different set of audience that I'm addressing.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it is like today's day and age,
right,
that needs to connect to this love story.
Right, I'm sure they will. Vicky, it's been a fabulous year for you. So tell me what to expect. I mean, your fans, you can talk to them directly and tell them what to expect from this one.
I think a clash of many different flavors, a clash of many different colors, a clash of many different worlds. When we talk about, say, an Anand Del Rai and collaboration of Anand Del Rai and Anurag Kashyap coming together to say a love story based in Amritsar. So that plus the music of Amit Trivedi, I think the album of this this film is pure genius, and the range that this album has is pretty amazing. And it's a good story. I'm sure they will be pleasantly surprised with the treatment and the approach towards that story.
Right.
They will connect with the characters and at the same time be kind of see a different shade in all three of them. So I guess, yeah, there are many elements, but I'm just very excited for them to see the film.